This is News Front. An eerily calm has been felt in rebel-held areas in Donetsk, subject to repeated bombardments, before Kiev and separatist rebels ordered their units to stop all military action, in accordance with the Minsk peace deal, signed in Belarus last Thursday. Donetsk People's Republic head Alexander Zakarchenko said that they have complied with the ceasefire agreement that will be effective on midnight of February 15, but they will suppress any provocations that may be organized by Kiev forces. Ukrainian President Petro Poroshenko has also ordered Kiev troops to cease fire, in line with the agreement. The spokesperson of Ukraine's Joint Staff, Vladislav Selesnev, has confirmed that all shelling of Ukrainian positions has stopped at 3 a.m. local time. Before the implementation of the ceasefire, both sides reported to have been engaged in artillery and missiles strikes. Ukraine government reported that rebels have pounded Artemivsk, a town in government-controlled territory north of Debaltseve, with rocket attacks. Donetsk and Lugansk was also subjected to artillery and missile bombardment, while Kiev forces attempted to retake lost areas in Logvinovo that serves as the lid for Debaltseve, but was repulsed by the Novorossian armed forces. In Debaltseve, a key transport hub is surrounded by NAF forces. An estimated 5,000 remaining Ukrainian task force is trapped in a pocket and reportedly running out of munitions and ordnance while making attempts to break out. NAF forces controls the outlying areas weeks before the ceasefire agreement brokered by German, French, Russian and Ukraine leaders in Belarus. At a summit in Minsk on February 11, 2015, the leaders of Ukraine, Russia, France, and Germany agreed to a package of measures to alleviate the ongoing war in the Ukraine's Donbas region. The talks that led to the deal, overseen by the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, or OSCE, were organized in response to the collapse of the Minsk Protocol ceasefire in January. The new package of measures is intended to revive the protocol, which had been agreed to on September 5, 2014. The Minsk II text, signed by the parties, calls for immediate and full ceasefire, in particular districts of Donetsk and Luhansk oblasts of Ukraine, and its strict fulfillment starting February 15, 2015. Heavy weapons should be pulled out by both Ukraine Army and Novorossian Armed Forces on minimum 50 kilometers and a security zone of 70 kilometers for tactical missile systems from actual line of contacts. Fresh local elections in Donbass shall also be called upon the formulation of the special status for the rebellious regions, amnesty for the rebels, release and exchanges of the prisoners of wars, and safe access to humanitarian aid to the affected areas, and full restoration of social and economic connections to the people in rebel-held areas previously stopped by Ukraine government. Disarmament of illegal groups, pull out of foreign armed formations, military equipment, and also mercenaries from the territory of Ukraine under OSCE supervision with the support of the Trilateral Contact Group. The Minsk meeting is an apparent attempt to prevent the war party in the United States, at the advice of the Ukrainian government, to send lethal weapons to the Ukraine army that will be viewed by Russia as a provocation and may result to a regional conflict. However, the observance of the ceasefire on the part of the Ukrainian government is on the shaky ground. Since the neo-Nazi right sector leader, Dmytro Yarosh, expressed that he did not intend to observe the ceasefire in Donbas and will continue their fight against the rebels. Latest reports indicates Kiev forces has resumed shelling of Donetsk civilian population hours after the so-called ceasefire. The leader of Donetsk People's Republic, Alexander Zakarchenko, has called an emergency meeting Sunday regarding the violation of silence regime in Donbas by Kiev forces. Poroshenko declared that once the ceasefire will fail, he will declare martial law in the country. Meanwhile, Zakarchenko warned that the ceasefire observed by NAF forces are only effective elsewhere and not in the Debaltseve area. He said that the entrapment near Debaltseve is situated on the territory fully controlled by the rebel forces. This is interpreted that Minsk agreements on separation of the warring parties do not apply to the encircled Ukrainian servicemen. He added that there are no negotiations about the entrapment is currently underway with Kiev, so attempts of the trapped Kiev forces to break through will be dealt with. Days before, NAF forces have been firing empty artilleries with leaflets to Kiev soldiers in Debaltseve Cauldron, urging them to surrender. The blockaded Ukrainian troops have been offered to turn in their weapons and surrender, but very little number has surrendered, due to the presence of retreat-blocking detachments of Ukrainian nationalists, guarding the troops in the rear of their positions and are shooting deserters. It is evident that the rebels are not letting a repeat of a scenario happened at Donetsk International Airport early this year, allowing Kiev soldiers to be replenished with supplies and weaponry while being trapped during the duration of the ceasefire declaration. He furthered that the DPR territory includes the entire Donetsk region, and they are demanding for a de facto independence from Ukraine. Their demands will be met either through the political process or other means. Zakharchenko said that the rest of the Donbas region is regarded as temporarily occupied and will be liberated politically or militarily. Political way is preferable, as it helps save human lives, but if politics does not succeed, we've already drawn attention to our capability to solve issues militarily, and not once for that matter, he said.
News front.
This is News Front. An eerily calm has been felt in rebel-held areas in Donetsk, subject to repeated bombardments, before Kiev and separatist rebels ordered their units to stop all military action, in accordance with the Minsk peace deal, signed in Belarus last Thursday. Donetsk People's Republic head Alexander Zakharchenko said that they have complied with the ceasefire agreement that will be effective on midnight of February 15, but they will suppress any provocations that may be organized by Kiev forces. Ukrainian President Petro Poroshenko has also ordered Kiev troops to cease fire, in line with the agreement. The spokesperson of Ukraine's Joint Staff, Vladislav Selesnev, has confirmed that all shelling of Ukrainian positions has stopped at 3 a.m. local time. Before the implementation of the ceasefire, both sides reported to have been engaged in artillery and missiles strikes. Ukraine government reported that rebels have pounded Artemivsk, a town in government-controlled territory north of Debaltseve, with rocket attacks. Donetsk and Lugansk was also subjected to artillery and missile bombardment, while Kiev forces attempted to retake lost areas in Logvinovo that serves as the lid for Debaltseve, but was repulsed by the Novorossian armed forces. In Debaltseve, a key transport hub is surrounded by NAF forces. An estimated 5,000 remaining Ukrainian task force is trapped in a pocket and reportedly running out of munitions and ordnance while making attempts to break out. NAF forces controls the outlying areas weeks before the ceasefire agreement brokered by German, French, Russian and Ukraine leaders in Belarus. At a summit in Minsk on February 11, 2015, the leaders of Ukraine, Russia, France, and Germany agreed to a package of measures to alleviate the ongoing war in the Ukraine's Donbas region. The talks that led to the deal, overseen by the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, or OSCE, were organized in response to the collapse of the Minsk Protocol ceasefire in January. The new package of measures is intended to revive the protocol, which had been agreed to on September 5, 2014. The Minsk II text, signed by the parties, calls for immediate and full ceasefire, in particular districts of Donetsk and Luhansk oblasts of Ukraine, and its strict fulfillment starting February 15, 2015. Heavy weapons should be pulled out by both Ukraine Army and Novorossian Armed Forces on minimum 50 kilometers and a security zone of 70 kilometers for tactical missile systems from actual line of contacts. Fresh local elections in Donbas shall also be called upon the formulation of the special status for the rebellious regions, amnesty for the rebels, release and exchanges of the prisoners of wars, and safe access to humanitarian aid to the affected areas, and full restoration of social and economic connections to the people in rebel-held areas previously stopped by Ukraine government. Disarmament of illegal groups, pull out of foreign armed formations, military equipment, and also mercenaries from the territory of Ukraine under OSCE supervision with the support of the Trilateral Contact Group. The Minsk meeting is an apparent attempt to prevent the war party in the United States, at the advice of the Ukrainian government, to send lethal weapons to the Ukraine army that will be viewed by Russia as a provocation and may result to a regional conflict. However, the observance of the ceasefire on the part of the Ukrainian government is on the shaky ground. Since the neo-Nazi right sector leader, Dmytro Yarosh, expressed that he did not intend to observe the ceasefire in Donbas and will continue their fight against the rebels. Latest reports indicates Kiev forces has resumed shelling of Donetsk civilian population hours after the so-called ceasefire. The leader of Donetsk People's Republic, Alexander Zakarchenko, has called an emergency meeting Sunday regarding the violation of silence regime in Donbas by Kiev forces. Poroshenko declared that once the ceasefire will fail, he will declare martial law in the country. Meanwhile, Zakarchenko warned that the ceasefire observed by NAF forces are only effective elsewhere and not in the Debaltseve area. He said that the entrapment near Debaltseve is situated on the territory fully controlled by the rebel forces. This is interpreted that Minsk agreements on separation of the warring parties do not apply to the encircled Ukrainian servicemen. He added that there are no negotiations about the entrapment is currently underway with Kiev, so attempts of the trapped Kiev forces to break through will be dealt with. Days before, NAF forces have been firing empty artilleries with leaflets to Kiev soldiers in Debaltseve Cauldron, urging them to surrender. The blockaded Ukrainian troops have been offered to turn in their weapons and surrender, but very little number has surrendered, due to the presence of retreat-blocking detachments of Ukrainian nationalists, guarding the troops in the rear of their positions and are shooting deserters. It is evident that the rebels are not letting a repeat of a scenario happened at Donetsk International Airport early this year, allowing Kiev soldiers to be replenished with supplies.